Well, it's a cute little church. Not super impressive, but I guess it will do for a rural British town with a few people here. Still quite nice. But yeah. Cathedral or what? Get the fuck out. These weird sounds freak me out. I can't help it. Just so happens that it weirded me out. Okay, I'm gonna follow the road up here just in hopes that this is the right path. It's, I have no idea where I need to head. Drive slowly. I'm gonna keep going this way. Wait. Nope, it's closed. We're quarantined in. But I'm gonna walk up just to see if there's something at the end of the road. Maybe an event that we get to watch. Nope. I'm gonna head down here. Man, this is rural as snark. Yeah, I'm gonna go with snark. Go ahead and sue me. Can I squeeze through you? Yay! There's a soccer ball. Let's see if I can shoot it. Is there blood on the soccer ball? Oh, I can stand on it. I can balance on the ball. Pretty impressive. Yeah, I hear you. I hear you. I'll listen. What do you gotta say, Kate?
Electrical failures all over Tower 6.
Oh no.
The light is flowing like liquid.
Oh, yeah.
Its sense of purpose is overwhelming.
Oh, yeah.
There's something in... Steven?
Oh, no.
Steven, is that you?
Nope. No, it wasn't Steven. I have no idea who that was, but certainly not Steven. A quick look. Can I check out the shed? I mean, I doubt there's something of value for me in there. Oh, it's just a garage. And it's completely empty. How unrealistic. Nobody actually keeps a garage completely empty unless it's freshly built. But there's just stuff that accumulates in these places. If you have room, it will be filled up with stuff. That's, I wonder if that's a law of some sort. It certainly should be one. It certainly should be a law. If you have a shelf and you just put an empty shelf into your room, you know, with no intention of filling it with anything, it will be filled with something. You'll start filling it with things. And then you gotta get more things, so... Can I open this? Because this is not... It's blocked, but not blocked off by the police. When I wake, I make weird rustling noises. Weirds me out. Okay, what's going on here? Oh, yep, it's open. Snazzy. Very snazzy.
Meg? Meg, are you here?
Here. I'm in the lounge.
There are too many empty houses tonight. Most of the village is gone now.
My head's killing me. Have you listened to the phones?
No, I thought they were all dead.
There's a strange kind of static now. I think I heard numbers in it. It sounded like the American woman.
Kate. She's still alive. No one's seen her.
Is Charlie back?
Not yet, no. I'm sorry.
That's all right, Father. Listen, you go on ahead. I'll just rest here a little longer.
Sleep well.
Well, it's very nice of you to check in, whoever Meg was. Ugh, gross tissues, bloody tissues, and medication. That's still on. Yeah, let's just put the towels right in front of this heater. That's a smart way to do it. And I'm seeing, I think, the observatory again. Maybe after going for the town, it will open up and I can check out the observatory. Might be interesting, but I'm gonna go up the stairs. How does that work with the rapture, by the way? I do wonder, when you get taken up, do you go with clothes? Because sometimes, I mean, when I what I remember is that, you know, you see the clothes laying around everywhere because they just go up naked. And again, I mean, would that be cool? Because I kind of feel that would freak some people out. All right, what are you writing down? Monday, I guess someone made some money. Accounts, I guess you're some sort of accountant. I wonder what time period this is. This must be like early 90s or so. I wanna say, no, not early 90s. I wanna say somewhere during the 80s because of these computers. Or mid 80s, mid to late 80s. Yeah, something like that, I'll go with that. Surprised that everyone has a personal computer in this game. Oop. Uh-huh, light switch. Good for me. Good for me. Very clean house. I like it. I bet we're going to hear the woman. Yeah, I don't want to listen. Thank you very much. So the woman disappeared. Kate. Nobody had seen her, but they heard the voice on the radio before. Maybe she... I honestly don't know. I honestly have no idea what these numbers mean. Anything on the open field? I mean, it lets me go here. I get to check out this beautiful machine of a tractor. Oh, there's a radio. Wait, that's another different kind of number combination. I just realized that. Well, it's a smaller one. I wonder what they mean. Maybe they can all be, you know, deciphered into a longer message or so. Just an Easter egg. Alright, I'm gonna guess. I guess I'm gonna head back. There's nothing here for me to find out. This looks like the end of the map over there. Very subtle, but, you know, clear. I doubt I can go in this thing. I'm gonna check it out regardless because I'm curious. Just curious. Nope. No luck. Huh. Well, horses, isn't it? Seems a little small. Oh, never mind. It keeps going back there. Well then. The horse is clearly gone, so horses also go to the heavens or wherever they go or were affected. Yeah, no pets, no dog, no cat, nothing of the sort. Ooh, hi. Ooh, I can check this out. Looks like, oh, that's a town hall meeting. Oh, I want to know what's going on there. Oh, wow, that's not a big meeting, is it now?
What about the station?
That's shut down too. So there's no way in or out of the valley. They're obviously serious about this flu thing.
Phil doesn't think it's flu at all. He said he's been practicing medicine for 30 years and he's seen plenty of flu and he said this doesn't feel right at all.
Well, there's nothing of any use on the radio.
Sorry I'm late, everyone. Have you started?
Yes, but to be honest, there's not really that much to discuss. This quarantine is in place. There's roadblocks and everything. No one really seems to know anything, but people are definitely missing. More of them too, not just a couple of old biddies. No one's seen the Sullivans since yesterday and the house is just sitting there unlocked.
I just got back from the farm. All of Frank's cows died in the night. He's devastated.
Ooh, okay.
Oh man, hasn't he had enough for 1 year? First Mary and now this.
Well, if no one's coming in to sort this mess out, we're just gonna have to do it ourselves. Barbara, get Phil to do a stock take on medication. Jeremy, put the word out for people to congregate at the village hall. It's best we get everyone in one place for the time.
Oh, that's a good idea if it's contagious. Yeah, let's get everyone in one place.
There's plenty at the depot, but well, let's start with what's here in the village. I'll draw up a rota. Charlie, you help me with that?
Anything for you, Meg.
I'll head out into the valley and scoop up the isolated families and check in with Lizzie Graves at the camp. Has anyone seen or heard anything from Stephen Appleton or his wife?
Nope, they're all gone. Stephen is gone. We had that earlier. Some suitcases. I guess they started to congregate here. Some of them, at least. And then disappeared. So the cows died. So that's a thing. It's a bummer. And that doesn't seem necessary. I mean, honestly, I have a hard time believing this is, like, the actual rapture. Maybe it's just some really, really weird disease. Because if it kills cows and, you know, you're bleeding from your face holes, I don't know if that's necessarily good. Ooh, one of those things. I forgot what they're called. Never played with them. Actually, the first time I played with one of those, you know, like the jumping, I think I was like over 20. I've seen them plenty of times, but I don't know. Never been that kid in school that got to play those kind of things in a more, you know. Just exchanging QBasic codes. Printed out QBasic scripts. Yeah, that's the kind of shit I did. There's something lying there and I want to know what it is. Oh, that's a rugby field, isn't it? It better be a rugby field. There better be something there. Michelle. Michael. Well, whoever was here is gone now. I doubt he's gonna come back. Well, that was fairly interesting. Maybe we're going to make full circle and go back to the observatory. That might be entirely possible. Excuse me. Yeah, those all look like pretty old cars. Wait a second. Oh, there's the symbol again. Is that the developer or something? Is it like a developer logo? Because I saw that crudely painted on something else, and it's not a car logo. This is very intentional. Maybe it's a little Easter egg or so. That's entirely possible. I'm bad at finding Easter eggs straight from the get-go. I usually have to do a second run of a game, similar to Firewatch. I just kind of like play through it, and then I look through it, but I kind of want to make sure that I catch most of the interesting things in this village. But it looks like, yeah, we're going back, doing a big roundabout, big circle. I guess Jeremy guided us along. Haven't seen him in a while. Haven't seen the light that I got to tune in. Oh, talking about that, there's something. Yep, there it is. Hi. There it is. Come on. No, I get what I need to do. I just gotta find the right position. So pretty.
Doing? I saw you doing that.
Go away from me. Don't come near me.
This is people's property. You're scaring them.
It's all over the village. It's got into everything. It's so fast.
What are you talking about?
It's traveling down the wires.
Dear God, man, you've lost your mind. Where is Kate? What have you done with her?
Don't you understand? It's breaching the quarantine and adapting.
Give me that bloody can. Hand it over, Appleton.
No, get off.
No, Sam, stop it. You weedy little shit.
It's mine.
Give me the can.
I need it.
Grow up.
Starting to manifest itself everywhere.
Stephen, come back.
Oh, Christ.
And he's gone. Huh. Interesting. Kind of looks like it came out of this can. Maybe that's why they were referring to it's manifesting itself everywhere. Huh. Chop close. Sorry, Dave. That's okay, Dave. I totally get it. You know, everyone's dying. That's a good reason to turn stuff, to close things. And can't go back there. That's okay, the two. Haverton welcomes you. I feel like, did I miss something? No, probably not. Let's see. This house seems modeled out and looks like I could go inside. Oh, what a pretty little path. Damn, I'm paranoid. I'm hearing people wandering around. It's just the butterflies. The flutterbys. Alright then. Valis Observatory. Say no to Valis Extension. Is a seventh tower really necessary? To register your complaint, add your name to the petition and make your voice heard. Someone didn't like the tower.
Hello? Hello?
Oh, Amanda, I thought you'd left town.
We tried. We did try.
She dead.
They closed all the roads and you can't get through. And then Georgie and Ben said they had headaches. And then they started bleeding.
That's some fantastic voice acting, by the way.
It was horrible. They were so scared. So Neil turned the car around and we saw the house was open. And I know we shouldn't have, but we just came in to clean up the kids. And then Neil and I started bleeding as well. And it's all over my blouse. Everyone was so tired.
It's all right, Amanda. Everything will be all right. Just try and calm down and tell me where Neil and the children are.
They're upstairs. They were tired and Neil said they could take a nap in the bed. And, you know, we thought Barbara wouldn't mind as their only children. And I was so tired, so Neil took them up. He took them upstairs to tuck them in.
And?
That was 6 hours ago. I never came back down. Just be too frightened to go and look.
Why don't we go and look together? I can hold your hand if you like.
He dead.
Yeah. I think I could manage that, yes.
Good guy, Jeremy.
Help me.
Of course I'll help you. Neil? Neil, are you there?
And that's where it stops, so we might never know. Huh. Well then, I want to know what happened to Neil. Okay, that's closed. It's a bummer. What about this one? Nope. Can't open that either. This one's open though. Well, that's the kid's room. Mommy. It's a creepy looking mommy drawing. Ugh. You know, if there would be a person like just appearing all of a sudden standing in the doorframe, I would scream so loud. I'm not expecting any jump scares. This game is jump scare free as far as I know. It's just, I don't know. Playing video games ruined me in that regard, that I always assume something's lurking around the corner, where I turn around and someone's standing there screaming in my face. I'm so ruined. Well, I guess they're... Oh! Yeah, I guess they're dead. Let's listen. See if it's a different combination. It's hard to understand, but it's a different combination. It's a different number. I guess it doesn't make sense to write them down. And I'm pretty sure someone must have done this at some point. So if there's a meaning to it, somebody's probably already working on it or cracked the meaning. We'll learn it at the end. I'm not going to bother now with writing this down. Wait, what? Does the fridge have a light switch? Seems like it. Good for the fridge. And I'm out. Later, suckers. Oh, wait. It's another... Wait. Haven't I been here? No, it's a different greenhouse. It just looks familiar. And I can't go in. That's okay. I think it's kind of nice. That's kind of neat. I would probably put a lot of plants in there. But I guess that's just me. It's just what I would do with a greenhouse. But hey, I like it wild. I live on the wild side of things. All right. I think we're done with this house. It's going to cross over. I wonder if they where that car is. Maybe that's their car. Who knows? Okay, what's going on with this house? Wait. Oh, yeah, we're back. We are back. I'm just going to shuffle now back to the observatory. Because I kind of feel I went through a circle. I'm going to have a quick look at the map while I'm at it. So this is our map. You're here. We went into the town. I thought? Yeah, this is closed off. We are kind of like limited in. So I'm going to go and check out the observatory in the hopes that maybe it opened up again. Huh. Everything you need to know is down there. I'm going to see. Come on. Nope. No luck. No cigar. What's going on here? Well, that was a letdown. Nothing here. I guess I'm going to head back and see what I missed. Just occurs to me that I actually haven't followed the main road in the town. I think I should do that. All right. Let's go over the bridge. Maybe something's gonna happen. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Well then.
Is everything alright?
Get out of my way.
Where's Kate?
Where do you think she is?
Stephen, what's going on?
Screw Kate. It's all her fault anyway.
What's that?
Oh my.
Stephen! Stephen!
Well, that was short. I don't know what that is about. I guess he then walked to the store. Oh! The church bell is ringing. Huh. Maybe the game wanted me to walk down the main road in the first place. And I just went the wrong way. That's entirely possible. That I just went the wrong way. Because things are changing now. That's new.
Are you there? Can you hear me? Are you out there, you bastard? You got them all? You got them all?
Oh, wow. Someone has a spiritual crisis.
Jesus Christ. Help me, oh Lord. Give me strength. Hello? Hello, is anyone there? Is anyone still there? Oh, oh. You are still here then. I should have expected that.
Who's still here?
Let's get this over and done with. I've got my parishioners to attend to.
So, are you going to get it over with me? Let's hear what's going on. I'm just gonna walk in and assume that the game wants me now to walk in. And there's another one. Oh, yep. Hi.
Their line has gone out through all the earth, and their words to the end of the world. In them hath he set a tabernacle for the sun. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Oh God. Oh God.
And he's gone. Well, I guess he got taken as well. I wonder if he was the last person. And again, I'm still here. Well, that's a thing that happened. I'm glad he doesn't have to deal with us anymore. Can I exit for this maybe now? Nope. Looks like it's dark outside now. Oh, wait. What's going on here? What are you guys doing here? What are you flickering about? I see ya. Ooh. Subtle. Where are we going, I wonder? Well, looks like we've got permanent night mode now. Which would be ideal to go to the observatory with, wouldn't it? Kinda makes sense to check that out at night. Yep, looks like it might be a short path. Shortcut to that. Something definitely changed. I have no idea what. Oh, hi. I wonder if that is Jeremy, because, you know, we saw his name written before, and he's like that one spirit that keeps roaming around. Maybe he's going to... Yes? Oh, Wendy. Hi, Wendy. Okay, so I guess we dealt with Jeremy's timeline. And maybe now we're going to experience Wendy's. That would be my best bet. Because we had a lot of Jeremy scenes. I'm following you, Wendy. All right. Oh. Do I get to climb? Oh, I get to climb over something. Amazing. Oh, it's a cottage somewhere in the forest. God, it's pretty. So pretty. I do really like forest environments in games. Oh, excuse me. I'm following. You're too slow for me. And this is a very well visualized one. I always feel that forests are never dense enough and the trees are never high enough. What? Yes, you want me to go inside? I can do that.
Dog ever so drawn this morning?
That bloody dog kept me awake. And there was that thing in the sky. The radio says it was an electrical storm, but I don't know what it was. This morning, I found some dead birds in the garden.
Oh, no.
I wonder if it might have had something to do with the atmospheric conditions.
Why, Stephen will probably know. I'll give him a call in a bit.
Wendy, I've popped around because we've had some incidents with some of the more elderly residents. Mrs. Boughton has, well, vanished, for want of a better word. Wandered off somewhere, no doubt. I thought I'd best check and see you're all right.
The council are talking about a flu epidemic.
Yes, well, I'm not sure it's flu as such. But no headaches, nosebleeds, no joint pains or digestive issues.
Dr. Wade, I'm as fit as a fiddle.
Well, now you're dead.
Go and find some real sick people to look after. And if you see that son of mine, tell him that his mother's looking for him.
All right, so yeah, it looks like we're going to experience more of Wendy's former life, I want to say. I mean, that's her floating around. She's basically guiding me around. So I probably could have been faster with the whole Steven timeline, I want to say, if I would have just followed his orb around, which I'm not going to do with Wendy here. I don't know where she's shooting to. Oh, are we going to another town now? Or are we going to back into the circle? I don't know. I'm still seeing you. You're not... I'm seeing you, Wendy. Take it easy there for a moment. You're just rushing back and forth. Wait. This is somewhere else, isn't it? Okay, where am I now? Did they model a whole... Oh yeah, Tipwar Forest. We actually made it through there. Well, show me what's up now.
Going away, Amanda?
Oh, just for a few days, yeah. First thing in the morning. I don't want the kids to catch this flu if it's going round.
It's probably that Father Jeremy spreading it around while he tries to bully everyone into donations for the summer fete.
Oh my.
Seems very quiet in the village actually, Wendy. Not much bullying to be done.
Oh, Father. I didn't know you were here.
Clearly. Listen, I came up here to tell Amanda that we've had some vandalism in the village. Must be a teenage thing. Tagging, I think they call it. Someone's painting all over doors and things.
Little vandals.
That's weird because, yeah, I've been wondering about them too.
Locked up when we go.
And then
a good man like my Eddie.
Stephen took the paint.
And these thugs and yops running around defacing property. He gave everything to his country, and look what he got in return. Nothing but an early death.
He had a good life, Wendy.
He had a short life. I look to my birds, Father. Lives lived unencumbered, free and simple. That's as God meant things to be.
Well, you're free to just go and, you know, live in the woods or so. Nothing simple. Up. I hear it. I have to find the radio. Probably something from Kate. Oh, treehouse. Can I go? I bet I can go up there. Yay, we can. Well then. Oh, we actually have to.
Every computer in the observatory has set itself to 6:07 a.m. June 6th, 1984. I don't understand what that means.
Okay, I wrote that down just in case. I never know, you know, I'm probably not going to need to enter anything anywhere, but maybe, you know, since she says, like, I don't know what that means, maybe we're going to learn more and then we can make some connection there. 6:07, I forgot p.m. or a.m., given that's, I guess, a.m., All right, then. We got a little shed here. Well, good shed. Good talk. Glad we had that. More books. Is that a bird book? Hard to see. A wishing machine. My favorite kind of machine. Oh, it keeps going down. I know I'm not supposed to be here. I'm supposed to be following her down the street, but I can't help myself. Give it a look. Usually given up. I think there's a radio as well. Nope, it's just a suitcase. Someone did a picnic. Adorable. You're here. What does that mean? Oh, a lookout point. Aw. Pretty. So pretty. Well, again, let's head back. Back onto the road, I want to say. I have no idea where Wendy floated. Is it going to bring me back to the main road? I hope it does. Going through some little forest path. Hope that's not going to be a problem. Yep, I hear a phone. Where is it? Where is it? Somewhere in the car. Oh, that's where Wendy's floating around. Anyway. Easy there, Wendy. Take it easy.
We got as far as the Haverton substation before we cut the lines. The interchange there just started dialing numbers at random.
And the symptoms you're seeing match those we've been tracking here?
Sickness, headaches, nosebleeds, eventual hemorrhage, then...
death.
Light. Whatever the hell that means.
Then we've got to stop it before it finds another way out of the valley. Clive, you've got to order a strike.
What?
An airstrike. We have to kill it.
No. No, I don't agree. We've quarantined the valley, we've cut the lines, it's contained.
What if you're wrong? Are you happy to have that on your conscience?
Stephen, I said it's contained.
Well, I'm glad we had that talk happen. I mean, they didn't nuke it, obviously. Or airstroke it. Airstroke it. I doubt that's the correct form. Where are you? What are you? I'm following you. Airstroke it. I love that. I'm gonna keep that. I'm gonna put dibs on that. Oh, it's like a junkyard. Very cool. What are you saying? I hear another phone. What's up with the phones laying around everywhere? Everyone has like one of these fancy phones.
Hello, Frank Appleton.
Oh,
great arms, cowboy. This is traveling Sherlock. You copy over?
You damn bugger, Charlie. You don't do it when you're using the phone.
You'd say this too seriously, Appleton. I'm telling you,
it is serious. It's not larking about.
You'd be listening to your number stations again, Frankie.
It's not funny. It's serious stuff, and you should mind it. Now then, I'm assuming this is about a pint.
I am going to the Whistler. My round, I think.
I'll never argue with that.
Frank, have you seen the sky? It's amazing. Don't think I've ever seen anything like it.
I didn't realize we were off to a poetry recital as well, Charlie.
That was weird. They're just having a casual conversation. Oh, what's back here? Just some woods. Okay, it's fenced off. No need to follow. No need to follow. Oh, hey there. It's laying on the floor. Oh, it's a dead bird. What, Wendy? What? What do you want? What do you want? Dead bird. Poor dead bird. Oh, there's more dead birds laying around everywhere. That
called this morning. Said there was a problem with Harvey. Said he couldn't get through to the vet, so I said I'd come round and take a look.
There's a lot of dead birds today. More here, too, poor little things. I've been trying to get hold of Stephen. He always knows what to do.
I don't know, from out.
No sign of either of them.
With any luck, the stupid creature will have run under a car. It's probably rabies.
Well, aren't you a cheerful woman, Wendy? Or birds. More dead birds. He looks... no, he doesn't look alive. Kind of the laying on the floor, not moving thing. That gives it away that they're not alive. You heard it here first, life pro tip. What? What? Heard like a squeaky noise. Oh, birds. Harvey. I see birds.
Harvey, come on, boy.
They're not all dead. That's good.
Come on, Harvey. Come on, boy.
Harvey.
Harvey.
He's dead. Probably. Given that so many other creatures died, the cows died. Oh. Pretty sure Floaty Wendy wants me to go along here. No, well, that's a pretty brook. What? What? I'm going. No need to
push it. Push the bloody thing.
You push it. I told you it would get stuck.
Should have just taken the car. This was a stupid idea.
Moving here was a stupid idea, and I told you, Barbara said they blocked the roads.
Barbara says so.
You go and look then.
Wait, is that Harvey? Harvey? Harvey!
Harvey? Here, boy! Come here, boy!
Maybe we're gonna find Harvey. I kinda got a feeling that Harvey's dead. Probably dead. I'm not getting my hopes up, otherwise I'm going to be sad if I hope he isn't. That's the saddest thing. That's the one thing that will make me weep like a little kid. Dead dogs is very sad. Anyways, off to happier topics. Dead birds. Oh, do I get to tune in? Yes. Oh, there it is. I wonder why sometimes we have to tune in.
Married. You have to stop this.
He's still sweet on you, Elizabeth.
He left. It's too late.
You loved each other long before she came along. It's just about making things as they should be.
Wendy, no.
It's not like you won't bump into each other anyway. One drink, what can that hurt?
One drink, maybe.
Oh, one drink, wonderful.
You're trying to hook up a married woman, Wendy? That's not cool. She's married. Were you trying to hook her up? That's so cool that the day of time changes. It's actually, you can see the sun move around, the shadows change. That's neat. Very neat. I'm coming, Wendy. You silly goose. Any more dead birds there? Nope, that's just some leaves. That's, you know, just leaves. I gotta say, it's a very, you know, clean place. Not even some dirt here in the road. Very clean. Eh. Oh, another radio with crazy numbers. That's always good. Hi. Ooh.
Phone call from Steven. He wants to shut down the receiver. Something about instances across the valley. There's intermittent electrostatic discharges radiating out of Tower 6.
That's not good. You should shut it down if that happens.
The main gate are blown. I'll find time to take a look once the data stream begins to calm down here.
What have you done, Kate? It's all your fault, Kate. Why would you do this? Always the crazy female scientist that summons the Rapture. It's the oldest story in the book. Well, I do appreciate that we get to see more than just the little town. For a while, I was worried that we would just get to explore the little town, but this is such a beautiful environment. I'm really glad we get to check this out.
Should we go down?
Just leave it. We've got to keep moving.
Sean, we can't just leave him. He must be really badly hurt.
Jesus, Diana, we've got the kid in the car. We should just keep driving.
We can't just drive off and... Look, he's there. He's in the car. Oh, he's hurt. We've got to get down there.
I said, leave him. We've got to get out of the valley while we can.
Oh my God, he's trying to undo his seatbelt.
There we are. He's fine then.
Well, that's great. Sean, you ass. Sean. Unbelievable. What an ass. Someone had an accident. But no, it's fine. Let's just leave. Yeah, he must have gotten off the road and sailed all the way down here. Huh. Let's see if I can maybe learn something from this. No, there's nothing. Nothing that happens. Oh my. Yeah, well. Oh, he's not fine. He's not fine. If that happened and he was in the seat. Yeah, he's not fine. He got impaled with that stick. Absolutely impaled. Well then. So much for being fine. Am I making those ripples? Water looks a little fast here. Little hectic. Still pretty. Still pretty. Could use some tuning. Little statue over there. I'm coming, Wendy. Give me a moment. Trying to catch up with you. Okay, where are you going? Guys, sounds creep me out. Some transformer, it looks like. Oh, we're going here. Tipworth Gorge. Gorge. Ah, alright, this is where we're going. What then? Wait, you want me to go there or want to go back? I'm not too certain what's happening.
Oh. Grief, Wendy, you'll catch your death.
They're all dead, Father. All of my birds.
Here. Take my jacket.
Good guy, Jeremy.
To be a good woman. A Christian woman.
You don't do that by hooking up another woman.
Just as the Lord forgave you, so also should you. What matters is we try our best. God sees that. Come back to the village with me.
I'm not so far from Stevens now. I need to find my son. It's what Eddie would have done.
Yes. Well, Eddie's dead.
I suppose it is. I'll say a prayer for you.
Thank you, Father. She loved you, you know, Mary. You helped her. I'm sorry if I judged you harshly.
It doesn't matter, ma'am. It's late. You should find a place to sleep. I'm sure when the sun comes up, everything will seem better.
I have my doubts about that. I have my doubts about it. Well, all your birds are dead. Sucks to be you. That's a bummer. I would be severely bummed out if I looked out of the window and, you know, birds would just lay around dead. That would be kind of frightening as well. What do you do in a situation like that? Sorry, singing people, choir. I'm kind of wondering, what do you do if you just see, like, let's say like 20, 30 dead birds out your window just laying around? You should probably call someone about that, shouldn't you? That seems to be the rational thing to do. I'm sorry, Wendy. I gotta go up here. Somebody spent a lot of time modeling this train, and I'm going to look at that sucker. You judge me. You go and judge me.
Boom.